We do have sad news to share with you. We have just learned that self-made billionaire, philanthropist, former presidential candidate Ross Perot has died. He was 89 years old. Of course, you will know him for his two runs for the presidency, both in 1992 and then again in 1996. Our Wolf Blitzer has a look back at his remarkable life.
H. Ross Perot was already a mega-successful businessman when he leapt into the American consciousness as an independent presidential candidate in 1992. His folksy manner...
And I was down in Texas taking care of business, tending to my family. This situation got so bad that I decided I better get into it.
And his laser-like focus on the economy...
We have got to stop sending jobs overseas.
...made Perot one of the most successful third-party presidential candidates in U.S. history. He won almost 19% of the vote in 1992. From the beginning, Perot's campaign struck a chord with those seeking a third-party candidate. He threw his hat into the ring on CNN's Larry King Live.
Number one, I will not run as either a Democrat or Republican because I will not sell out to anybody but to the American people. And I will sell out to them.
In a presidential debate, he attacked both Republican President George H.W. Bush and Democratic challenger Bill Clinton with equal vigor about the nation's debt.
Now, it's not the Republicans' fault, of course, and it's not the Democrats' fault, and what I'm looking for is who did it.
Perot also directly challenged both candidates' support of NAFTA, the North American Free Trade Agreement. Perot feared it would cause the loss of American jobs.
There will be a giant sucking sound going south.
Perot's campaign against NAFTA continued beyond the presidential race. The Clinton White House responded with a challenge, a one-on-one debate with Vice President Al Gore, live on CNN, with Larry King as moderator.
Yeah, I'm listening. Okay. I haven't heard the answer, but go ahead.
That's because you haven't quit talking.
Well, I'm listening. How do you stop it without NAFTA?
Are you going to listen? Work on it.
It was watched by millions of viewers. Just over a week later, NAFTA passed both the House and Senate. It took effect on January 1, 1994. Ross Perot was born in 1930 in Texarkana, Texas, where his father ran a cotton mill. He graduated from the Naval Academy in 1953 and spent 4 years at sea. He started electronic data systems in the early 1960s. It later became one of the world's largest technology services companies, processing data. Perot became a billionaire in 1984 when he sold a controlling interest in EDS to General Motors for $2.5 billion. A couple of years later, he started a second data processing company, Perot Systems Corporation. It sold to Dell in 2009 for almost $4 billion. In 1969, President Richard Nixon asked Perot to seek better treatment for U.S. prisoners of war in North Vietnam. He traveled to Laos, where he met with ambassadors from Russia and North Vietnam. Perot made headlines again in 1979. When two EDS employees were taken hostage during a revolution in Iran, he organized and paid for a successful private mission to rescue the men and bring them home. Perot ran for president again in 1996, but this time he was barred from the debates, so he bought network airtime and broadcast a series of infomercials to explain his personal vision for America. Perot won only 8% of the vote in 96. Wolf Blitzer, CNN, Washington.
All right, our Jamie Gangel joins us now on the phone. And Jamie, of course, our thoughts with his wife, Margot. He is survived by her and their five children together. You covered him for years. Tell me what he was like.
I think that Ross Perot, Poppy, was perhaps the original maverick. We use that term a lot, from his voice to his style, very plain spoken. Before Donald Trump captured the American public, certainly Ross Perot did as an independent. He also didn't listen to the people around him. He was, and by that I mean the political advisors. When I covered his campaign, they would say, you know, do this or don't do that to him, don't do interviews. And he really ran his own ship. But I think from my years covering him, the thing that stood out to me was his role as an independent candidate when he got in the race with George H.W. Bush and Bill Clinton, because as Wolf just reported, Perot got almost 19% of the vote. And if you look back at those numbers, I know the Bush campaign really felt that Perot was a spoiler for the Republican candidate. And there were several reasons that George H.W. Bush lost that re-election, but a lot of it they blamed on Ross Perot, Poppy.
They did indeed. What do we not know? What do most people, Jamie, not know about Ross Perot that you think they should know as we remember him today?
You know, I don't think we should forget. At the time he ran, I think he was very much in the public consciousness, and people knew that he was really a self-made man. He grew up in Texarkana, as I recall. He went into the Navy, became a salesman for IBM, and very quickly became a top employee. No, not a surprise. He was a good salesman, as we then saw in his political career. And then after he left IBM, he started electronic data systems in Dallas and once again just soared to the top. I think the other thing that, you know, Wolf mentioned this, but it's very important to remember, he was a driving force behind the MIA movement in Vietnam. He really pushed very hard and spent a lot of time, effort, and money on trying to bring MIA back and resolve that.
Well, Jamie, thank you so much for this. I mean, you had years covering him, and I really appreciate you calling in. I'll just leave everyone with this. His son, Ross Perot Jr., asked to describe his father, said, obviously a great family man, a wonderful father, but at the end of the day, he was a wonderful humanitarian.